Привет! Как дела? We started with learning the Russian alphabet. Then we moved on to reading syllables and a simple dialogue. And last time we covered some useful words and phrases. So I hope that by now you don't have too many issues with recognizing Russian letters and reading in Russian. Today we'll learn the phrase that I think anyone going to any foreign country needs to learn first. It's, excuse me, do you speak English? If you have no time left before going to a Russian-speaking country, you may at least learn this. Saying it in Russian, you're showing consideration and respect to the locals, and people may feel more eager to respond or help you. First of all, when approaching someone you don't know in the street, there is no need to say «Здравствуйте», because it's not really catching attention. You should start with «Excuse me» and in a formal way. We learned this phrase and the difference between addressing someone formally or informally in the previous video. So, based on that, what would you start with? «Извините» or «Извини»? Right, the formal way of saying excuse me is извините, and you know it because it ends with te. The whole phrase will sound as извините, вы говорите по-английски. Вы means you. Вы говорите means you speak. Or do you speak as a question. There is no difference in Russian. We'll talk about this more later. По-английски is an adverb. It means in English. And you read it as one word. По-английски. And once again the whole phrase. Извините, вы говорите по-английски. Извините, вы говорите по-английски. Great job! Now, what can a person say to that? They may answer, да. Я говорю по-английски. Repeat, please. Да means yes. Or they may say, нет, я не говорю по-английски. Я говорю по-русски. Нет means no. And you can also see that to make a negation in Russian, you just put не before a verb. And though you write them separately, you read them as one word. Не говорю. Try to not confuse нет, which means no, and не, which means not. Kind of the opposite from English. So, when you need to talk to someone in a Russian-speaking country, but you can't say a lot in Russian yet, what would you say? Right, you would say «Извините, вы говорите по-английски». If you hear «Да, я немного говорю по-английски», what does it mean? It means I speak English a little bit. Я немного говорю по-английски. Repeat, please. You may say Я немного говорю по-русски. Mm-hmm. Or instead of немного, you may also hear чуть-чуть. Чуть-чуть. And if you hear извините, я говорю только по-русски. It means, sorry, I only speak Russian. You may say, я говорю только по-английски. What if you speak some other languages too? You may say, for example, я говорю по-испански. Я говорю по-французски. Я говорю по-итальянски. Я говорю по-немецки. Let's imagine you want to say I speak English and Spanish. Я говорю по-английски и по-испански. И means and. Я говорю по-английски и по-испански. Try to say, I only speak English and Spanish. Я говорю только по-английски и по-испански. Now, try to say, I speak English, French and Italian. Я говорю по-английски, по-французски и по-итальянски. And now, try to say, I speak English and a little bit of German. Я говорю по-английски и немного по-немецки. Try to apply it to yourself and your own language knowledge. What is important to understand here is that по-английски is an adverb. Compare it to an adjective with a noun. Английский язык. Английский is an adjective. It describes a noun. And по-английски is an adverb. It describes a verb. That's why you say английский язык. But по-английски. Русский язык. But по-русски. Try to read these. Испанский язык по-испански. Итальянский язык по-итальянски. Французский язык по-французски. Немецкий язык по-немецки. Great job! Now, to sum it up, what have you learned today? You've learned how to say, excuse me, do you speak English? Извините, вы говорите по-английски? You've learned how you can change this phrase and about some possible answers to it. You've learned that и means and. And you've learned how to say yes and no. Да, нет. And you learned how to make a negation in Russian. Я говорю по-английски. Я не говорю по-английски. See you next time. we'll talk about verbs and patterns for conjugating them. Увидимся!